So hello everyone and welcome to the second video on blended learning. My name is Jens Myrup Pedersen. I'm associate professor at Aalborg University and the video here is done as part of the EPIC project. In this presentation I will tell about how to do stuff in Moodle and I will show you how to build up a blended learning course and how I have done it. I will demonstrate what I think are some of the most important functionalities and what I will go through is videos, quizzes, assignments, and then tell a little bit about how workshops can also be used. The demonstration and the examples I'm giving, they are based on a course which is given in Riga Technical University. So I'll find the course here. But this is the front page. And it's really built up like any other thing in Moodle. But I've done it. I have a forum here. Then there is the overview of the course, a welcome, where I'm telling exactly how I'm organizing it. And then it's built up into different themes. Before I go into, and every theme I can say is finished in some way, that could be a quiz, or it could be an assignment, or more assignments, in fact. So if I go down here, I will see that I have a quiz repository. And that is a bit of a workaround because Moodle apparently doesn't allow me to put quizzes any other place than on the front page. And if I put all my quizzes on the front page and all my videos on the front page, it would be super messy. So I've put the quizzes here and then I can link to them from the sub pages just by making hyperlinks. So if I look at how it's organized, I can, for example, I can go in here and take the videos and quizzes for the first theme. And then the structure is kind of, there is a video. There's a quiz, there is a video, there is a quiz. If I try to look at what it looks like, I can go to the edit settings here. And then I can see that the page content is really a list of links. So I have a link here to the video, which I just inserted as any other link. And then it works perfectly in YouTube. Then there is the first quiz, which is just a hyperlink to my workaround on the front page. A title on the second video, and then here is the link. And I can probably even, if I go here, can even remove the link or change the link or edit the link here. So it's really easy to edit or insert or remove links just using the interface here. Of course, it's also possible to can try to do it here. I can just insert a video. And then I can just upload it to here. But personally, I prefer to put things in YouTube because I know it works on all different kind of platforms. Okay, I don't want to save my changes here. But this is basically how to set it up. So if we look a little bit more on the quizzes, and then I will go to the front page, and I will show you how to set up one. And to do this. Well, let's try to make a new one here. Let's try to make a test. Test of quiz. Because the problem is if I cannot really mess around in quizzes that are already running and all the quizzes in this course has been taken by someone. So here I make it a test of quiz and then I can insert a quiz by saying add an activity or resource. Actually I have a lot of different things I can do here. I have the assignment that I will talk about. But I take the quiz, and then I add it. I put the name, I would call the name a test of quiz. And then I see I have a lot of different options. If you don't want to bother about it, you can just leave it. But otherwise I will show you, you can set the timing so you can decide when to open the quiz. So when it becomes possible to access it, if it is closed at some point. I usually don't use it. And personally, I don't think that this is a good place to put like an exam because we don't really have a way of controlling who is solving the exercises. I can put a time limit. I can tell what happens when the time expires, and I can even put a grace period that it's so it's possible to work a little bit later. So allow a grace period, then you can submit, but you cannot change any responses. So that's giving some extra time. I can look at the grading. So basically I can look at how many attempts the students are allowed to do. So unlimited or with a limited number, I can put a grading method to see if they are doing more attempts. Do they get the highest grade, average grade? Do we look at the first or last attempt? Usually I don't use the grade so much, I would just say highest grade. Layout, I can see if I want to put everything in one page or if I want to have multiple pages. And I can have question behavior. It's actually also nice to see if I should shuffle the answers within the questions. And I can see how questions behave. I can see if different attempts, if they build on the last or if they start from scratch. Review options, so see when I can get my feedback. A lot of different things here. I can also put a restrict access. So I can, for example, say that they cannot access it until something has happened. So for example, only students who belong to a specified group can access it. I can prevent access until a certain time. But for now I will just save and display. So now I get my quiz. But I still don't have any questions in my quiz. So in order to get questions inside, I can use a question bank if I have some questions already, but I don't. So here I would have to create a new question. And here you see that actually there is a lot of different opportunities. So I can use the classical multiple choice, which is what most people consider what you do of automated quizzes, where you can allow one or more answers. You can make true, false. You can have a short answer, a numerical answer. I personally like to use the numerical ones because you can ask questions which are more, which are not just a guess and multiple choice option. Calculations, essays, matching questions where you have to match. When you have, for example, you can have multiple different and a number of questions and a number of answers, and then they have to find the right match. So different options. Of course, not all of them can be auto-corrected. That's also what I like about using the numerical one, is that they can get the feedback straight away. Whereas if they're writing an essay, then you have to grade it manually. So assume now that I take the multiple choice. So what I have to choose here, I will not go into detail because it would take a lot of time, but you can play around it on your own. A question name, a question text. And then I can actually choose if I want to allow one or multiple answers, like, you know, if there is a dot or a box to tick, if the choices should be shuffled as well. So sometimes you don't want it to be all the same, like it also makes it easier for students to help each other. In this way, it will look different every time. And then you put the question text here, and then you give the different answers down here. So choice number one would be one answer. I choose a grade, 100%, 50%, or I can even put it to be minus. The most important is that it should add up so that students who can actually achieve 100% of the grading. But that could be that for example, you can have two choices which are both correct. Then you could give them 100% each. Or you could say that the students have to choose multiple options, and then they would have to get 50% from here and maybe 50% from here. And then of course I also need to put the choices here. What more is interesting? I can choose what mark I can get here to kind of put the weighting between the questions. And I can also give the feedback, so depending on what the students is answering, he can get different kind of feedback. It's something I haven't explored myself too much, but I think there is a great potential in it because you can spot the typical mistake. And if you know that if they made this kind of typical mistake, then this is the guidance they need. And if they need make another kind of typical mistake, then it's another kind of feedback they need. So this was a little bit about the questions. Of course, a question bank you can import and export, so you can take it from other courses. You can build up a library of questions. Essentially, when you have the quizzes, just put it here. So when you have the quizzes, you can also take random questions from different parts of the bank. So you can, for example, instead of having, if you want to give 10 questions, but in 10 different categories, you can define 10 categories of questions and put a number of questions in each category, and then you just randomly draw one of them to pick the question. That's quite interesting. And that's also what I can see when I go to the edit quiz. So here I have this possibility to shuffle. Now I don't have so much to shuffle between. If I go out again and then look at the assignments. Assignments are nice, but the challenge is that they require a grading on their own. But here I've just put an assignment saying, please read these articles. I can see now there are 26 participants on the course, actually 17 submitted, I only graded 10 of them because they were submitted on time. So I have at some point I have to do the rest. But then I can view all the submissions, I can get a list, and then I can correct it here. For a long time I used to get assignments sent by email and it was a mess, and it was hard to check that everyone had delivered an order. You had to keep a track of it in some Excel sheet or some manual way. But it's actually really nice that you can keep it in here, and you also have the opportunity to give feedback to the individual students and have an overview of what grades you have given to different students. There is a nice, I haven't used it in this course, but there is a nice extension of the assignment, which is called a workshop. So the difference is that in a workshop, then the students can review work from each other. So assume that you have an assignment, then you can ask 2 students or 5 students or 1 student to review the assignments of someone else and give feedback and give comments. And then you can give grading of both the assignment itself, but also on the feedback from other students. And you can weight how much you weight the assignment and how much you weight the feedback that they give to other students. So in this way, you can do a kind of a peer review and peer learning process facilitated by Moodle. And it's actually, it works pretty smooth once you get the hang of setting it up. So you can define a deadline and you can say, okay, after the deadline, then you do the assignment of who is reviewing for whom automatically. And that works with both one-on-one reviews and if you're reviewing multiple of the assignments from other students. And you can put a deadline for when the reply should be in place and review should be in place and so on. But the challenge I found with it was that when people don't stick to the deadlines, then you have to sit afterwards and do some manual allocation still. So I would say that these workshops, they work better, or they work really well, but only if students submit things on time. So that's basically what I wanted to show here. Of course, you can do many other things in Moodle. I can just, if I go down here again in my test area, I can see how many different kind of things I can add. I said assignments, but you can also make choices, databases. Forums can be good, but I really didn't find a good way to activate students and make sure that they use them. Wiki, I think, can be quite useful, where you build up together a space with descriptions and so on from the course that the students can use. I know one colleague who used the forums or got the students to use the forums by saying that the only kind of notes they were allowed to bring into the exams was what had been on the forums. And I guess you can do the same with the wiki in order to encourage the students to use it more. So all these kind of activities are supported in this version of Moodle, and other versions of Moodle will have different activities supported. So that was a bit of an insight in how I am working with Moodle and the things that I've been doing. So for now, I will thank you for listening and enjoy, explore. Don't be afraid of trying out new things. Moodle can actually do a lot of different things in terms of blended learning. Thank you.